Hello everyone, my name is Brett. I'm part of the customer success team here at LearnWorlds. And today I'm going to be showcasing our brand new powerful analytics engine and our user progress feature. Before we begin, I just want to make sure everyone understands how much of a game changer user analytics actually is for our online schools. The ability to analyze, understand, and then act on your user data can actually help you improve your e-program's performance. For an example, an online martial arts academy that teaches various styles of combat would benefit from understanding which styles of combat are actually generating the most interest from their students. We also have the ability to identify problems using analytics. So we can look for problems, bottlenecks within our course content. So if we take a look at our data, we can actually see if there is an abundance of low test scores, or perhaps people are registering for a course and then dropping off a few days later, or during a certain section of that course. You know, right away we can see that there's an issue there. So the ability to kind of identify these issues and improve on our course content will actually lead to a reduction in student turnover, which of course leads to higher enrollment and of course higher revenue for the schools. So it's not hard to understand the benefits of including an analytics engine within the LearnWorlds platform. Let's kind of take a closer look at some of the newer features. User progress is one of the new features that is now available on the LearnWorlds platform. And what it allows is for simple and advanced queries. So we can take that information, we can drill into it, we can pull reports, and we can actually export those reports into a CSV or an Excel format. To get started, we're going to start with a couple simple searches, and then we'll show you the advanced search function. You can find the new User Progress button under the Admin tab on the left side of your screen. Using the basic search feature, I have the ability to select a course, apply filters, and make use of the sort function to drill into my students' progress. The results can be further analyzed by selecting an individual student, which will display additional information on their enrolled courses, study time, and course completion. In this example, let's take a quick look at all the students who have completed at least 50% of the course Ultimate Guide to Email Marketing. I can narrow down my 29 results by adding an additional filter for those who have completed the course. I see that I have 7 students who completed the course, and I'd like to understand who my most active student is. I can use the sort function to bring the student with the most courses to the top of the list. By selecting the student, I can view the progress in each enrolled course. I can see that this particular student has only completed 27% of the course, How to Sell Online Courses Using Facebook Remarketing. I'd like to understand more. By selecting more, I bring up a detailed list of all the different sections within a course, and I can see exactly where they left off. In this particular case, I might want to reach out to the student, see if I can provide them with any assistance to help them get back on track. Okay, so let's play the role of an administrator who caters to corporate clients. I may wish to run a user progress report on a specific customer, and I can do that by selecting a course, and then using the email contains filter to search for a particular corporate email address. Apply my filters. And as you can see, I have about 15 results of users with the exact same email address. Now, instead of actually climbing into these particular users, in this case, I'm actually going to export their data, use this detailed report, and download the zip file. Now, you can see that this report contains a simple summary of each user, the progress status of each user in each section of the course, the time spent, and any scores that they might have. And I might want to go ahead and send this to my customer's management team so that they can evaluate the success of the training. It can be very difficult to stay on top of your new users. They have a tendency to sign up for things, and if they reach any roadblocks at the beginning, they disappear. With user progress, this actually makes it very easy, and I'll show you how. You know, you can select a course, let's say Success Stories, And then we're going to use the registered filter to look for anyone who registered after a particular date. So in this case, we'll select June 14th, so a little over a month ago. I'm going to apply my filters. And right away, I see that I have 49 results. So I might want to further narrow this down. And let's look for students who have completed less than 20% of the course. And I see that I now have 10 results. From the information down here, I can see when they registered, and I can actually see when they last logged in. So why don't we go ahead and take a look at those who registered lately. Let's try this gentleman here. I see that he actually last logged in on the 18th, and he last enrolled on the 18th, and he has 0% completion on the course. So he signed up, looked at the course, and then kind of disappeared. This might be a good opportunity for me as an administrator to reach out to this individual to offer my help to get them started. So you can see how powerful something like user progress can be in the hands of someone who knows how to use it. Okay, so most reporting systems focus on user progress for a single course. The new advanced search within LearnWorlds actually allows you to create broader queries, which result in a diverse group of users enrolled in not one, but several different courses. So what this means is you can actually extract the course progress for each one of those users and all of their courses all at once, which is an absolutely amazing feature for those who are exploring different aspects of their learning material or looking into their users' behavior. So let's take a closer look at the advanced search with a couple examples. As a course administrator, it's important to understand when your users run into trouble with your course content. If we can identify those who started a course but never finished it, it's possible to follow the data backwards and identify when a user decided to call it quits or perhaps even why. In this example, I'm going to identify users who have enrolled in more than 6 courses but have received 0 certificates. So these are folks that actually are active in the school, but just have never completed a course. So choose that, and number of certificates. So let's do 5 courses, exactly 0 certificates, apply. So you can see right away, I actually still have 142 results. So there's a lot of people to crawl through. Let's just choose somebody who has a lot of courses. You can see some of these have signed up for 15, 14 courses, 13 courses. But again, these folks have never received a certificate, so that tells me that they're, you know, signing up for courses, but not completing them. So there's something, as a course content creator, there's something I need to look into there. Are all my students doing this? Is it just this particular couple students here and there? Let's see if we can find somebody else. So this person has spent 1 day on the platform, most likely within here and here. Let's see, they spent a lot of time with the main video, the instructional videos, and the quiz. But when it came to how to choose a camera, they decided not to watch the video. And then they watched the video and called it quits. So if I had created this course, I might want to see if I can understand why they decided to call it quits after the about audio recording. Perhaps, you know, they weren't interested in lens types, or, you know, maybe they want to look into this course with multiple students and see if it's an occurring reoccurrence. Because if that's the case, it's the content, and the content needs to be updated. So you can see it can be a very powerful tool. Especially in identifying students that are active and just not completing the courses. So let's move on to the next example. As we mentioned before, sometimes users will call it quits not long after they start. Identifying these users early on and reaching out to them with the assistance can help you keep them on track. In this next example, let's use the advanced search to identify at-risk users who signed up a little over a couple months ago. And this time we're actually going to focus on a particular course. So why don't we say they are enrolled in the Ultimate Guide to Email, or they're enrolled in the Ultimate Sales Guide, or perhaps they are enrolled in the How to Market Your Online Course. Next, we'll choose At Risk. And registration date was after, let's say, May 1st. So right away, I have about 40 different users to look at here. Why don't we go ahead and see if we can narrow this down, actually. Let's try to bring the registration date to June 1st. There we go, three users. So these are three at-risk users who are enrolled in either the Ultimate Guide to Email Marketing, the Ultimate Guide to Sales Readiness, or How to Market Online Courses. So let's take a look at these users. This particular user registered on the 5th of June. They haven't logged in quite some time. I can see that they've only completed about 38% of the course. They've only spent about an hour in, so let's kind of dig into that. It looks like they are jumping around to particular pieces. They're skipping the quizzes. Try another user. So you can see these users have signed up. They haven't signed on in quite some time. Same here. This user skipped particular areas and decided to call it quits when social media came up. So as a course content creator, I might want to reach out to them and say, you know, I saw that you signed up for this course, but you haven't continued with it. You know, is there anything I can help you with? Why don't we go ahead and show you what this looks like and if we actually export it. So we have a couple different courses that have been signed up for. We're going to export the user in a detailed course report. And I can see that I actually have a detailed report for each particular course. There's a summary, so this person has progressed to this point. The information is a little bit clearer in the spreadsheet. You can see how long they spent in each particular section. And if there were any scores involved, you can see that they have scores here. Let's check out another one of the courses. So it's very easy to jump into the information and figure out where the students are dropping off. Time spent. And you can see that this particular student looked at these sections. And this is in a spreadsheet, so you can, you know, go ahead and add filters and fills so you can easily identify the information. Very easy to use. So you can see how an advanced search can actually help you here, because you can look into multiple different courses and find your at-risk students. Include also, you know, registered at this date, and you can actually continue to include filters to even further narrow it down. For our last example, I'm actually going to be running a search for my active users, who are usually the users that are most engaged in my school, and you're usually enrolled in more than one course at a time. But I want to find active users that are enrolled in a specific course that have only completed anywhere between 0 to 20% of that course. So let's go ahead and create a filter for that. Active user, and the user has completed a specific point in the course. Let's say between 0 and 20% of the course. Let's go with success stories. Apply filter. Now right away I have about 32 results, so I'm going to look for someone who's spent a lot of time on our platform, like this particular user. And I can see that they might have been active here, and they seem to be active in this course here. They haven't completed it yet, but success story, they've only completed 16%. So although these users are active and they've spent time on the platform, for some reason they have not continued their research into success stories. So that might tell me a couple things. As a course content creator, I might be worried the fact that, all right, these guys are actively engaged in my school. They complete a lot of my courses, like this one. This particular, it's completed a lot of courses. But once they got to success stories, they just were like, it's not for me. So as a course content creator, I might want to look back and see if there's something I need to change within that to make it more engaging for my students. Thanks for taking the time to watch this video. I hope you now have a better understanding of our analytics engine and our user progress feature. In my next video, we'll be discussing user segments, which is the second half of our analytics engine. It allows you to create advanced searches in the blink of an eye. Remember, LearnWorlds is getting better every day, and I look forward to sharing all the new features with you.